So you know what's cool about these combats too is that because there's all the different cards that the monsters use, the different not just the different decks, but obviously you know there's many more cards in each deck than you take for the monster or being each time you have a combat. So the combats are always different, you know. So in other words, this is an entire deck of Ravager cards, right? That's the deck that the Black Serpent uses. So I'm only picking nine of them, right? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine of them right there. I mean, and then, you know, if he goes into a battle again, he might pick a different nine, you know? So, I mean, even each combat is different, even though, you know, even more different than just the fact that they use different decks. I mean, they could have used different decks, but had always the same cards in them, you know what I mean? And then it would just be your choice. Excuse me, what card that you're going to play every time, you know, based on who you're going against, blah blah. But they made it so there was even many more cards. It's very cool. So he gets nine cards in his deck, and then that was the Ravager deck right there. So that's what the Black Serpent is going to use. And poor Eleanor, she doesn't have really that many. She only has these cards right here. So that's kind of a problem. But again, she has that rest card, so she'll be able to draw two more cards. That's kind of a race in the hole, and she might actually get a really good card. You never know. Well, actually, although I kind of wanted to get that charge back, but I don't know, the cancel is really good, but it's ranged, so most of his he might play ranged, but most of his cards are are melee cards. So she normally now she would say how much agility she's using to draw cards or to add to strength, but she can't because she's helpless and her agility was reduced by one. So she doesn't have any actually agility. Doesn't say reduced by one to a minimum of one either, so I'm gonna guess that means zero. I think that's a fair ruling because of what that card says. I could be wrong. Leave me a comment if that's wrong. But anyway, okay, so first card, I think she might play. See, that's rough though, because she's going to take some damage there. But you know what? She has a full deck, so I think it'd be a good idea for her to just play this right away, her rest card. And it doesn't cost anything to use. No strength right there, zero. Draw up to two cards from the top. Maybe rest pull that I pull. She's going to play that. And then this guy has nine cards to play from. And he thinks she's probably going to do ranged, most likely. Let's see what he's got here. That's a lot of cards to choose from, man. Got a couple parries, poison arrow, hack. What is that? Gain plus one attack if your opponent plays a melee card. Cancel your opponent's ranged card. That's pretty good. But anyway, let me figure out what I want to do. So I'm going to say this anticipate card would be good to play. Next round, your opponent must play a combat card first and must play it face up. So that's a great card to play. The other one, hack, gain plus one. If, no, I'm sorry. Charge, cancel your opponent's ranged card. There's a good chance that he would think that she would play a ranged card because her deck is mostly ranged cards. So these are set up because there's doubles in here like that. So the, wait, what was that? That was charge, so could play anticipate, could play charge. This is actually a pretty good one. If you deal at least one damage this round, deal an additional two damage. So that's definitely a possibility. This is a great one. Cancel your opponent's ranged card. No, I already said that one. Probably not. Yeah, and aim shot. So we'll do one, two, three, four, five, six on this. All right. Let's see what we got going here, kids. Cancel your opponent's ranged card. Okay. Well, that's good for her because she didn't play a ranged card. All right. So the Black Serpent, cancel your opponent's ranged card. It was not a ranged card. Drop to two cards from top of your whole deck. But this still does two injury to her. Notice that she this rest does not give her any defense. So she actually has to take two injury, two damage, I think they call it. Yep. That's the damage pool. But she gets to take two cards, draw up to two cards, and she didn't use any strength on that. He only used one, so that was pretty smart. Draw up to two cards from the top of your rest pool or life pool. So here's a thing. So two from the rest pool would actually give her back her charge. Cancel your opponent's ranged card. That's actually in the Ravager deck too. But see, he doesn't have a lot of ranged. I mean, he might play a ranged card, but it's hard to say when he's going to do that. And ranged strike, gain plus two, plays a ranged card. So I think she's actually going to gain two from here, from the life pool. It said that, right? Yeah. So she, we got a parry. Plus two defense if your opponent has a melee card. That's good. And hide. Next, she has a hide already. Yeah, next round, gain plus two defense if you play a ranged card. All right, so next round. What is she going to do? Let's see. This parry is actually pretty sensible because it's very likely that he will play a melee card. And it only costs one, remember. She has this card that costs zero. But she might get hit again, but she still has a pretty big deck. But this is a really great way, because see, she hasn't paid any strength yet, and it's a really great way of kind of wearing them down. I think she's going to play that. That's a good one. These are both hide cards. Oops. All right. What does the Ravager play? Ravager already spent. Well, he only spent one. Okay, I think he's going to play this Anticipate next. Next round, your opponent must play his combat card first and must play it face up. That's actually a pretty good card. Well, that's a good one too. If you deal at least one damage, that makes sense. Gain plus three to win. Doesn't think it's going to match because she played a melee card last round. Melee, cancel your opponent ranged card. The charge, that's sensible. Once again. Wait, did I? No, he just played a charge. Yeah. Okay. So it's between these three cards right here. We're going to do a... By the way, if they ever do a... or if I ever try to create an actual solo version of this game, it kind of could be done sort of like this. You know, like... If you want to make it very similar to this game, you could do it with not a very complicated way of doing the AI. So the intelligence of the foe player, because I would think if it was a solo game, you would play the player and you're fighting against Sauron, who was the AI. I think it would be easiest to do it that way. Though it'd be kind of interesting being able to do it both ways. But you could sort of do it with this way, where if you had a bunch of these cards that kind of have like a little programming on them, like if this is this, if that is that, and then maybe you just like roll dice and see which one the actual guy picks. And that'd be kind of fun, because you're hoping that, you know, the die comes up with this, and if it comes up with that, you're like, ah, kind of similar to this. But anyway, so we're gonna do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we got two, so it's gonna be a charge once again. Okay, that's bad. That's really bad. Because what that does is it cancels your opponent's ranged card. And that is a ranged card. So next round, so you actually treat this card as if it was blank. So she doesn't get that next round ability. Gain, plus two attack, plus two value. That's really bad. That's too bad that came out like that. Any other one of these cards wouldn't have been that if it would have came out. If that dice roll would have been different. Yeah. Okay, so that's too bad. But then actually still does, it also does two injury. So this card is like completely ruined. And she has two more injury on her. Wow. This is not going good for my Eleanor Rogue character, unfortunately, hero. All right, so what's going to happen next? All right. So next, so now she has not, now that, the Black Serpent used two, strength of 8. So he only has a 6 left. If he plays, she's thinking, if he plays, you know, if he already used a couple cards that were really low strength, if he only has three, another three, might not defeat her. Because she still has a couple one cards left, and she hasn't really played anything yet. I mean, maybe she's going to do this. Oh, this doesn't work. Jeez. Next round game, +2 defense. It would give her defense, but she wouldn't. I mean, unless she's just 100% totally committing to just tiring this guy out. Because if she thinks about it, let's see. He's got 2 points down already. That means he only has a strength of 6 left, right? Now, if he plays... Let's see, if next turn, you know, let's say he plays a 2-card and then a 3-card, he'd only be able to play 2 more rounds of 2 cards, right? So she could easily just wear him out. So she might do that. This card here, parry, only costs 1. +2 defense if your opponent plays a melee card. And it does 1 injury. Or anticipate would be a good one. Sometimes the only problem with anticipate is that if they do play it face up and there's nothing you could do about it. So you kind of want to play anticipate early, so in a way, so that you have enough cards that you can, when they do play their card, you can really do a devastating card against it. But I think what she's going to do instead... And he already just did play 2 melee. She might do hide. +2 defense. And I think her whole plan now is just to wear him out. So she's going to do that. She's going to play hide. And just try and wear him out so she does not get defeated. Unfortunately. But if she doesn't defeat this guy... But she's not going to. That's the thing. There's no way. She doesn't have enough. She just doesn't have enough. Unfortunately, the cards that she got didn't give her much more ways of doing damage, so she doesn't have enough. Right now, she's basically trying not to get defeated. So, +2 defense for the hide. Wait, next round we'll give her +2 defense, yeah, which will bounce that defense way up. Okay. I think Poison Arrow. If you deal at least 1 damage this round, deal 2 more. That's a good one for him to use. I think that's smart. He would use that, I believe. So Poison Arrow, if you deal at least 1 damage, but unfortunately that he did not because she has 2 shields. So the 2 damage hits the 2 shields and does nothing. She also does nothing. So we just go to the next round. She's only used 1 strength. He used 4 already. Right, 2, 3, 4, strength of 8. Only has 4 left. Only 4 left, folks. So he knows that. And he needs to... He has a couple 0 cards here, though, in the Ravager deck. See, she didn't know that. That can do some damage. +1 attack only if you're playing... Yeah. What was that last card? You deal at least 1 damage in any next round game, +2 defense if you play a ranged card. Yeah, so she's going to play this ranged card. It's the only ranged card she has. This is basically, like, again, just... She's just wearing him down. That's all she's doing. And he is going to do... He might do an anticipate so that... He can maybe do aim shot after that, which would be another... Yeah, this is a great idea. So he's going to do anticipate. Okay, next round your opponent must play his combat card first. Play it face up. And this automatically does 1 injury and has 1 defense. That gets defended. She doesn't do any injury because she has 4 actual right now. And next round gain +2 play ranged card, but she does not have a ranged card. And she's only used 2 strength so far, which is incredible. She has 5. She's actually going to run out of cards. This guy used 2, 4, 5, 6. and has a strength of 8. So he can only, oh geez, he didn't even think about that. He can't use his aim shot. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Strength of 8 only. He can only play these zeros, these ones, jeez. All right, so she's gonna do parry. She shows him that because of this anticipate. He knows that she's playing a parry, which only has one defense, so he's gonna try and, it's really too bad he can't use his aim shot, which is 3, 2, 4, 5, 6, yeah. Can only do something that takes, well, he only has 0 and 1 cards now. Wow, look at that, he can't do any damage. Okay, so gain +1 attack if your opponent's a man. So it did do a +1 attack, but her defense was up. Gain +2 damage from a melee card. So gain +2 defense if your opponent plays a melee card. So her defense is at 3. So that hack doesn't do any damage, even though it does 2 damage. All right, next round. She has used 3 strength, and he has used 6. 6 of 8 and 3 of 5. This is actually pretty interesting. Oh, except she only has 1 more card. So she has to play that card. And yeah. Next round, your opponent. So next round, there won't even be a next round because that's her last card. And actually, you know what? Her opponent can still be under what he needs to be. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I mean, maybe he would have done this, another hack. Gain +1 attack if your opponent plays a melee card, which she did. +1 attack is gonna give her 1 damage. Okay, so we're kind of at the point where this happens sometimes. So, I mean, don't, you know, you're thinking, oh my God, this is terrible for our hero Eleanor, but the thing is, just remember, for her quest, she needs to fight the, or what does it say, combat? Let's see, something. Combat the Black Serpent. So it doesn't say that she has to actually defeat the Black Serpent, she just needs to combat the Black Serpent. So she did that already, you know? That would have been nice if she had her, what I was hoping was for her to get her retreat card, but she didn't get the retreat card, so. That's okay, though, so anyway, but the thing is, this guy, since she is now exhausted, so what happens now is he gets to keep playing cards on her until she is defeated or until he is exhausted, which there won't be any defeat there, but there will be a couple more. He could play these 2 more cards, right? So he could play a parry and a parry, which gain +2 defense, gain doesn't matter. And so that's just gonna do 2 more injury to her, right? So 1, 2. And you would think her turn would be over, but she actually did combat the Black Serpent. So she gains 1 level of strength, and she receives training. And then we're going to place Denethor. Wait a second. Denethor is already out. So there is a very specific rule of the game that if they're out already, if the character's out already, then you ignore that text. 1 level of strength, which is the first time this is happening. So I'll show you how you do that, and receive training. So 1 level of strength, her strength is at 5. You were saying, like, well, when does her stats go up? So now, there we go. Jeez. Okay, so now in other games where they just give you, like, you know, they'll give you, like, a +1 symbol and then another +1, and you keep adding, like, +1 or +2 onto it. This is really much better, where you actually just put a 6. So now her strength is 6, and that's very easy to see, which means that she's going to be able to keep fighting longer, right? And she also gets to have training, so we saw that already. So we go to the training deck, take 2. We're going to pick the one that she likes. Hey, crossbow shot. Cannot be canceled, and it does 4 injury, and it only costs 2. Yeah, I'm probably taking that. Set trap. Next round, if your opponent plays a melee card, dealt 2 damage. Yeah, no. Whoops. We're not going to take set trap. So this actually goes in her hand right there.
And see, she was not defeated because she still has cards in her deck. She was almost defeated once again. These people are really getting off easy here. What's this aim shot? No, that's the Ravager. Okay. All right, so now that's the end of that battle. And this guy was not defeated once again, so his wisdom is one. So I am going to get to put one of these down. And right there for now. Don't let me forget that. And I'm going to clean up these decks.
All right, so now she finished her basic quest, or her starting quest. Now we put this Eleanor's advanced quest. So remember, for their mission, they need to complete all their quests, folks. So what does she have? Hidden in the Ash Mountains, the filth and grime of Mordor covered Eleanor. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. See, she's not afraid to get dirty. Covered Eleanor so completely, she was almost indistinguishable from the bleak landscape. Few had ever ventured so deeply into the Black Land. Day by day, that black thorn of malice, the tower of the enemy, grew nearer. That's Barad-dûr they're talking about, baby. Yeah, so she needs to, she needs to just explore Barad-dûr. Gain 2 favor or 1 level of agility, then remove 1, ugh, jeez. What? Come. Damn it. Gain 2 favor or 1 level of agility, then remove 1 influence from the shadow pool. Man, why do I got to do that? Put that in the little holder for Eleanor. Come on, you can see it. All right. Wow, that's bad. So even if I put... Okay, well, anyway, she's got to go through some... Oh, by the way, when I was able to put down one of these because she did not defeat the Black Serpent, I put it there in that place that I don't know how to pronounce. Pelargir, I'm going to say. But anyway, she's definitely got... And remember, she might rest and take this away, but she's still... Man, she really definitely needs to get... Oh, wait a second. Once per turn, gain 1 favor when you complete a quest. Yeah, she actually has 1 of these now. So she only needs 1 more, and she can get rid of 1 of these. So she can get her wisdom back up. But her wisdom is at 2 right now, actually. So as long as I have 3 on here, it's going to be a perilous journey for her. So when I have lots of opportunity to put down more, get more peril up in there. Need to get some monsters up in here, too. Jeez, you haven't even seen any of these monsters yet. Okay, so, and she's got Boromir there, too, that she can get 2 more of those. But if she stays there, then the Black Serpent... This is a really cool situation. If she stays there, the Black Serpent is... Well, but... Remember, she knew that I was going to try and get this down. But she also... But I also... I got another quest here, and she does not know that I... got that. So she might think that I'm going to abandon this quest because she saw it and try something different. Especially since that marker, the hunt for the ring, is all the way at 0 anyway. She might think like, he's going to use that other quest. But I don't know. I mean, I don't think it's worth it for her probably just to like sit there and then get ambushed by this guy and lose her turn anyway. So anyway, this goes to somewhere where there's a character. So I don't necessarily have to put it there. I think I'm probably going to, but it could go over where Gandalf is in Bree. It could go where Denethor is at that Grey Flood. Yeah, mouth of the Grey Flood. So they don't know exactly what I'm up to. Not exactly, even though they did look in that Seeing Stone, the Palantir. Anyway, okay. So that was actually the end of her turn. Let me see. Did I do everything? She got her favor. I put that down. She got her strength and she got her training right there. That's a great card. Really great. I mean, the only thing problem with it is it doesn't defend, but still, that's pretty good. Yeah. And she was just exhausted. She wasn't defeated, so she doesn't go back to a haven. Okay. They're not on any kind of influence. And then we go to the... Boy, this is seriously painful, folks. This is really painful for me right now. But we're going to the story step. Now, this one goes automatically, and guess which one of those gets moved up? Well, kind of none. Because, folks, got nothing down. Once again, because of that one stupid card, I'm complaining about it. This is maybe like the 10th or 11th time complaining about it. Because it took away my influence. Couldn't put that down, no. Anyway, that one. Would have had that down already, folks. Anyway, big deal. So, but now comes the plot step, right? Or I can put a plot down if I want. And guess what? I can actually put this plot down. They might not have known I was going to put it there. Maybe they did know. But this is a good place to put a plot right there, I believe, because he's there. So if they go there, they're going to have to fight him. And as you just saw, that's not very easy. Although she has that crossbow shot. That's interesting. That could do 4 injury. That will do 4 injury right off the bat. So see, it is good to get some training before you start taking on these guys. Anyway, urgent summons. I already read this. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, wow, I'm glad that I looked at this again. Affects the location of Sauron's choice that contains a character token that does not contain another plot marker. Boy, that's not a problem. When this plot becomes active, return all character tokens on this location. Well, that's pretty cool. Okay, so that's going to be my first plot, basically, or plot number one. Now, my whole plan was actually to put it here. And I think that might actually still be a good plan. Because, see, she's starting her turn there, right? Now, she's going to get ambushed right now, no matter what. She's going to get ambushed by this guy. The problem is, if she gets ambushed by this guy and because of this... Well, I don't know. No, let's see. The rest step comes before the ambush step. So she could actually rest, and then she could fight this guy and destroy him, and then get rid of this plot. It takes 3. She has 1. But no, because she won't have enough, even if she takes Dark Path. All right, so that's good. And especially if she tries to get rid of those. All right, so, I mean, I could put it... I mean, would it make more sense to put it up here, way away from them? That might actually make even more sense. Well, geez, there's nothing protecting it, and Barovor... She could just move 1, 2, 4. She could dislodge that plot like almost immediately. No, I won't be able to get a, see how nice they did that? So they're not exactly in second, but as close as they can be. No, I don't know. Maybe this was a crazy idea, yeah, because she is right there. And I guess really all she has to do is move and then come back. Can she do that? But all he'd have to do is just bounce on over. I cannot get a minion over there in time. This is my fastest moving minion. This poor guy here, man, he's not doing anything. But he can only move him 1 at a time. That's the problem. Yeah, I'm going to do that. I'm going to leave it there. All right, so Boromir, which is nice, goes back there. And I have this down, which hopefully that will start moving that up too. And then, man, if I can get some more of those plots, jeez, I'm hoping to get them. But we'll see. I don't know. I like that it's not affecting a haven location, which is nice. Okay, anyway, remember, she needs to go into Barad-dûr too. All she has to do is just get there and explore there. So she might be interested in doing that as well. Because this moving up too, by the way, it's my furthest... to the left, it's my worst plot marker, I always call these plot markers, but worst story marker ever in the game anyway, so I don't think there's that much of a, I don't think they're that really worried about it. Okay, that was the story step, that was the plot, and now is events. So we're still in the first, and yeah, we take the lowest card, which we have a 6, so that's pretty cool. See what this says. If it were not for the Beornings, the passage from Dale to Rivendell would long ago have become impossible. Gloin said that from Fellowship of the Ring. All right, the Beornings, yeah. The heroes may remove up to 2 monster tokens from or deal 2 damage to a minion in any location in Mirkwood. Oh no. Are you serious? Ugh, I think my freaking... Malthus Sauron's in Mirkwood. No, he's not. Okay, awesome. That's great. So, huh, where is that? Oh, okay, cool. That's fantastic. That's part of the Brownlands, I guess. Ah! Remove up to 2 monster tokens. Well, that's not a problem. I have no monster tokens down or do 2 damage in Mirkwood. I have nothing in Mirkwood. All right, fantastic. Boy, that's a low number. I'm surprised that's like just all good for the characters. Man. All right, whatever. Put Dane 2 in the Iron Hills. There's Dane 2. And he goes in the Iron Hills. Where's the Iron Hills? That's the Troll Shaws. That's not the Iron Hills. No. They are, I think they're really far north. Let me see here. Oh man, the Iron Hills all the way down there. And the High Pass gets a favor. Yep. All right, Holly Pass right here. Oh, there's so much favor on the board for these guys. I'm going to be running out of my cool spiel material tokens. All right, cool. Look at all that favor. Holy crap. So you can see it very well because of yellow flags. But this is a very interesting turn because of this whole situation going on here. So she was exhausted last time. Remember, that was like kind of like during her, that was during her travel step. She did not defeat this minion, so she lost the rest of her turn, right? But now what's going to be coming up on her next turn is what's called the ambush step. She can rest first, right? The rest step comes first. You have the rest step, and then you have the ambush step. So she's going to get ambushed by this guy. So you say, well, wait, that's a circle. That's going to keep going on. But the ambush step is a little bit more forgiving in that she, even if she is exhausted and he's exhausted, she can keep going on her, and if she defeats him, of course, she can keep going on her turn. On the ambush step, the only thing that will actually stop her turn is if he defeats her on the ambush step, right? So the first thing I'm going to do definitely is I'm going to put this guy on. I need some plot cards, definitely, without a doubt. So I'm going to draw 2 plot cards. And I got 2 plot cards right here. And I'm going to draw 2 shadow cards. And I like to do that. You kind of want to do that first because that might, where you're going to put that plot, if it is a plot that you may be able to put down, might influence your other moves on here. So, by the way, I just put this down. So you remove the other 3. So now the higher numbers are accessible. All right, let's see what I got with these shadow cards here. I got 2 of them. Oh boy, a 12. That's fantastic. I'm like, really? For each corruption card on the defeated hero, grievous loss. For each corruption card on the defeated hero, place 1 influence in the extension of shadow strongholds or into shadow pool. The green story marker advances 1 fewer space during the next story step. That's pretty good. But it's not going to happen. I mean, look at all these gigantically large requirement cards I have. Come on. Ah, and this is a 10. Seriously? Oh my God. That, those are not going to be able to be played until the third freaking... Ugh. Winter Storm, that is a very cool... I don't know who the artist is on these. It's really fantastic artwork on some of these. That looks like Game of Thrones, doesn't it? Play at the start of hero's turn. The current hero may not move more than once. Well, that's a fantastic card, but when the heck am I going to play that? I mean, I might as well just, you know, make these a nice stack with all these giant numbers on them. I could play the Storm of... Oh, my God. All right, so let's hope here. All right, folks, we're hoping that I am going to get a ring plot at this point because I have this plot in already. That's going to move 2. Let's move it some more. Here we go, ring plot, ring plot. Ah, it's mustering. Damn it. And I got rid of that last mustering one. Ring plot, ring plot, ring plot! Oh, my stars and garters, I don't believe it. Damn it! Jeez. This is actually a cool card. But, I have all these... Oh, my stars. Oh, man. What is this? Takes 5, which I'll have by next turn. What do these take? This one takes 5. So this is, these are similar, it looks like. Wow, they're really similar. Look at that. Worm Tongue taints Theoden, which comes really from Saruman. Saruman falls to corruption. That's pretty cool. And they both move corruption up 2. They both take 5. These are really, in essence, they have like kind of the same effect. Corruption. Worm Tongue taints Theoden. We got some. Yeah, it's okay. Requires 6 influence within one space of Edoras, or the Saruman falls to corruption plot. Oh, well, there's a nice one too, right? If I get this down, affects Isengard. Bing! Then I can automatically put this down the next. So I guess, yeah, that is a really good combo right there, but bam. Affects Edoras. When a hero consults with Theoden, he receives 1 corruption card, so. Okay. Well, that really tells me what I'm going to do here. And Edoras is right there. That's a little bit of a bummer to me when you put these in. It's okay. I mean, there's good stuff about it, but I think it's generally better if you get plots that affect places that are not havens. But at least I did get... Well, I mean, I guess that's all right. I kind of feel a little claustrophobic here. I'm a little like bullied into doing the corruption, but I mean, I guess that's what I always wanted anyway. You know what? I can put 2 down this time and 2 down next time, and I can have that up eventually. Affects Minas Tirith again in a haven, which kind of sucks, but I mean, because you saw what happened here, right? When you can put your minion on a plot. Well, if you put your minion on a plot, but it's in a haven, that sucks, because it's always the characters, like Eleanor's choice whether they want to fight in a haven or not. Sometimes they don't want to, so they could just stroll right in and boop. And plus, you cannot put monsters in there either, in havens. So it kind of sucks, actually. This Isengard one is better. I mean, I don't doubt that. This one in Edoras is going to, and this one in Minas Tirith, they're just going to get popped right out, I bet. I mean, even though this takes 5 and this takes 6, I mean, I'm just going to have to surround those places with peril and monsters and all kinds of stuff, which I should actually start doing this turn. Anyway, well, it has to go like this. I have to remember that. No, actually, first you got to put the Saruman. First falls to corruption, of course, before he can start tainting Wormtongue, before Wormtongue can start tainting Theoden. So I want to get this one down next turn, basically. So I'm going to try and do that. That's Isengard. I've already been working on that. I need to see, they can get into Isengard through the Gap of Rohan too. So I need to do something about that. I probably, instead of putting that there, I put it, okay, whatever. So there's that turn. That was a terrible shadow draw, let me tell you. I'm not getting good cards here, folks. I'm gonna actually play this card, believe it or not. I think it's a good chance of keeping that. Well, should I wait though? Because see, well, this moves it up 2, but I almost feel like this now, this plot, that's almost just a bluff right now, because seriously, like, I really just... Well, then again, I mean, all it would take would be drawing 1 plot card that moves that thing ahead, like, 2 or 3, and it would make this not a bluff, and it would make it, like, a very real situation. And I'm guessing I'm going to get a bunch of them, because I haven't been here. I wonder if you're allowed to actually look in here. Does it say to put them at the bottom of the deck? What does it say to do with the plot cards? I'm looking at them. Yeah, see, that's definitely... Oh my god, like the rest of these cards are probably going to be... I'm sorry about that. I wasn't doing good camera work there, folks. I think probably like the rest of these cards, or a lot of the cards in there, are going to be the Hunt for the Ring. So with that knowledge, I mean, even though I'm really I mean, but the thing is, I'm going to be really going for these. That moves that ahead two. That moves that ahead two. So that'll be moving ahead four. Maybe even seven. So should I even worry about this plot? Ah, I don't know. I could even use this sort of as a bluff anyway. Well, see, she might want to go over and do her quest too. See, the thing is, the only reason I would really want to be using this right now would be so she has to get rid of this card, because it would make her get rid of that card. Each hero must then discard one random card from his or her hand from each corruption card, so she would have to get rid of that. And I have to play it actually on my action step. So I couldn't wait, you know, until she drew more to do it. This one does four. I mean, she could just play that right off the bat. Wait, hold on, but I wouldn't even know that she has this. So that doesn't even, there's no way. You know what, I totally forgot about that. You're right, folks. Very good. All I know is that she just did training and got a card. This would be like this to me. I wouldn't know that she had that. So of course, although I could just say that, well, you know, it's Sauron. Sauron knows this stuff. No, so I wouldn't. There's no way I would have played that. I mean, I would like to play that right now, but in all fairness, I wouldn't, unless I knew something. I would wait to use that. I'm going to have enough for this soon, this Morgul Blade. Actually, play at the start of combat involving a minion. Deal 5 damage for each. Deal the hero 5 damage for each corruption card. Wow. That's awesome. Okay. See, now I feel like I have to freaking. Oh my god, this game is so amazing. But frustrating for Saruman. Yeah, okay, so, well, to get this plot down, I have to put some there. So I absolutely have to do this. This is all I've been doing, folks, I know. I know it's terrible, but I don't know what else to do, right? Two more. I mean, right, you see what I did? I mean, to be able to get a plot down next turn, I mean, unless I want to put this shitty-ass plot down. No. So I have to put these down here, right? So I've got to put two here, and I got to put the rest in the extension, and that's the end of my game. I want to do this action. I don't know. Okay, but what's good is I'm going to be able to put one in the Gap of Rohan, sorry, it's pronounced Rohan, I believe. Why did I want to do that? Because Isengard? Because it's, yeah, I need to make it difficult for them to get into Isengard. What is she going to do? She's going to get ambushed right now, right? And she's going to use that card and probably kill this guy and then do all kinds of cool stuff. I wish he had a battle motif going on, but he really doesn't. Oy, I'm going to be getting a couple more minions, which is nice for next turn. So, what's her? Wait, hold on. Who's going to be going up here? She's trying to do those quests. Trying to make it hard to get into Isengard because my big daddy, this quest here, whoops, moves it ahead too. Isengard, I can put this down next turn. I don't want them to pull it off. So if I make that a little more perilous, I think that would be a good thing. What's her wisdom? 3? And wisdom of 2. But her wisdom is actually now 2, but it might be up to 3. I have to put a lot here. Well, then again, actually, they could break this at any moment, and this would go down to 1, so. Which is pretty crazy, right? Could they break it, though? Because it's connected to 2 different ones. Yeah, all they would have to do is go. See how this Gap of Rohan Rohan and Isengard, they have quite a lot there, but that's if she wants to come this way. That one already doesn't have very much on it. But let's say if somebody just hung out and stopped right here, if they break this chain, all these go down to one. All these other ones here. Well, no, let's see. Yeah, it would have to. Doesn't matter because if they're breaking it, you know, if they broke it over here, then that would be different. But if they broke it here or here, yeah. And man, I need to get some influence in the Shire or get my ring race up there too. Or else I'm not going to be able to win this. All right, we're on the hero turn. It's Eleanor's turn. She is in very, very bad shape. Like really bad shape. She doesn't have any cards in her deck. And she has some, she just drew cards. She was supposed to draw six, but she didn't even have enough because remember she fought this guy. And she can't rest. Normally you would be able to rest, but that can't actually happen because if you're in a space with a minion, of course you can't rest. So good for me, bad for Eleanor. Eleanor just needs to like kind of hightail it out of there. So what she really needs to do is just not get defeated. Because remember, this is so she can't rest, so now we're going to go to the ambush step, right? So no ambush there. So Eleanor is getting ambushed by... Why do I have him like that? You can't really see what he's doing here. There we go. Watch out, Eleanor. See, this is that's symbolic of what is probably going to happen right now. Eleanor is... Wow, look at poor Eleanor. All right. So, yeah, what happens is on the ambush step, like I had mentioned, it's a little more forgiving than the travel step. During the ambush step, you can get exhausted, and it's okay as long as the other minion is exhausted too, or if you're not defeated as a hero, you can still go on with your turn, right? But if you get defeated, then of course your turn stops, and that's bad, right? But this is the ambush step right now, so there's going to be a combat automatically. She can't choose like if she was in a, you know, a haven. So there's going to be a combat right now. So normally she is going to... Okay, so she has one agility, but remember, she actually is... she's helpless. So she doesn't have agility. So normally her agility would allow her to draw more cards, and she doesn't have any cards in her deck anyway, so it doesn't matter. So she has a strength of six. This guy, remember, we uses the Ravager deck. So, and he pulls nine cards. So let's get that going. All right. So we got nine cards out of the Ravager deck for this Jack move. And the first thing we do is pick some cards, but wait! Dun, 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 dun. Yeah. Morgul Blade, right? Play at this, I almost think this card is like that's a typo or something. Morgul Blade. Play at the start of combat involving a minion. At the start of combat involving a minion, deal the hero 5 damage for each corruption card on him. I mean, that's like unbelievable. She actually gets 10 damage. I mean, what if you had like 4 corruption cards? This is like what I was saying. Like, you know, you might think it's no big deal to have these corruption cards, but there's this corruption card mechanic that's just awesome. By the way, did I talk about how great this artwork is right here? That's like, seriously, I would just put that up in my room. It's amazing. Or, and there's not going to be any or here, folks. Deal the hero 3 damage and give him 1 corruption. Yeah. Deal the hero 5 damage for each corruption card. Okay, so this is how this works. So I'm going to do this. I got 6, as you can see. I set myself up for that. Let's pop that right there. Now, so damage has to come from, of course, the life pool or here. And she only has... So she gets defeated before we even play any cards or anything like that. So all of these have to get put in her... Oh my gosh. So all of these cards that she had in her hand have to get put into her damage pool. She has no more cards in her She has no more cards in her deck or in her hand, so this is what a defeated hero looks like. Oh, Eleanor, you got defeated. My roguish hero. Oh boy. All right, so, well, that's actually, you might think like, oh, my stars and garters, that's horrible, what's going on? She's gonna lose, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, right, look at this. Did I show you this, by the way? Look how much they're leading by. That's, I mean, is that a mistake? That's insane. So don't feel bad for Eleanor. She's gonna do great now. But what she does do, actually, what does happen is she actually goes to the nearest haven to heal, you know, like Frodo did. And the nearest haven is this one. If there's two havens that are just as close, then Sauron gets to choose. So she goes there. And she gets to heal, basically. So she gets to take all of her cards back into her life pool. And I'm going to shuffle those, of course. Got to keep it fair, kids. Yeah, everything is gonna get back in there. Let me see what happens. She shuffles, and then the left. So here's a real bummer, and I just wish it wasn't like this. But she, well, it doesn't matter right now. But it's actually pretty good for Sauron right now. But what happens is you move the leftmost story marker. Remember, leftmost story marker, kids. You move that one space. So that's actually good for me because that guy's going up. Although I think really what I really need now is for the corruption to go up. So you're going to move that up one space and these are all in the same spot. And if there were two there that were tied, which this is the real bummer what I was going to say because I thought I did have two tied, but then the character, the hero, gets to choose which one to move forward. And I don't think that's right. I think, man, they got defeated. You know, I think the story marker, the one that goes forward, that Sauron should be the one who does that. But you know what? To be honest, Corey and Christian, they're so brilliant. I'm sure they did that because there's some very specific balancing reason why they did that. So that's, let me make sure that I know that these are all in the same space right there. There we go. Yeah. Okay. So that's a good thing, actually. And they actually have to lose one favor or one item. So she's not going to get rid of the horse, so she's going to get rid of a favor. One favor or one item. Not. I think earlier I said it's both, but it's actually one or the other. And she gets to heal, and that's it. So I'm going to shuffle these cards. You know, it's interesting. She might have actually defeated that guy. I think she had a good chance to defeat him. But now that really awesome card is somewhere in this... in this life pool, and we don't know if she's going to be able to draw it right away or not. So, a little bit of luck in this game. Her strength is 6. All right, that's the end of her turn. Actually, by the way, that's the other terrible thing that happens. So she did heal. She's all ready. What's actually nice is she's kind of away from this situation, and she could go boop right into her quest, or she can go and try and dislodge some plots. All right, so now is... Now, this person, Barovor, right, our lonely hero in Moria, who just had to take on a freaking Balrog by herself, she needs to rest. I mean, she, like, big time needs, she doesn't have any cards. So, her special ability is when you rest in a non-haven location, even if it's perilous, doesn't say that, but I'm just saying, even if it's perilous, which it is, you may heal or receive training. So, that's great. So, she is going to, I mean, look at her situation. She has to rest. So she's definitely going to rest. And she wouldn't be able to rest if there were monsters or minions, like for poor Eleanor, but there's not. So she can rest. So she gets to move all this back up in this piece. And she doesn't have to... when you rest too, you can get rid of corruption, but she doesn't have any corruption on her. Unfortunately, when you're defeated, there's no really mechanic for being able to get rid of those. Well, she wouldn't have any of those anyway, any favor anyway, so. Barovor needs to give her some of these, which she could do. So anyway, let me shuffle these up. All right, so she's all rested up, all good, but the bad thing about that, of course, if you rest, The leftmost story marker needs to go up, and they are all the same, so it's her choice which one goes up. So of course they're going to put up this useless one, the mustering, because they haven't seen any sort of mustering situation go on. All they've seen is corruption and the hunt for the ring. So that's cool. All right, so now is her travel step. There's no ambush because there's no minion there. And she actually, it's funny, she still needs to go to the ruins of Angmar. Where's the ruins of Angmar? That's like way up there. Yeah. She still has this Black Pit quest to do, because now there is no, there's actually no Balrog there. So, there's this interesting rule in the game where if you start your turn in a location, you can kind of skip your first travel and peril step. So I can't all of a sudden say like, oh, it's perilous, you're there, because she started there. So she can go right ahead and explore here. She doesn't have to do her combat or peril. So exploring is like, you know, retrieving favor, consulting with people. She could choose a dark path, and also completing quests. So she actually then completes this quest. Just says explore Moria, gain 2 favor and receive training. So that's awesome. Wow, so look at all the favor that she has. This is crazy. She has an insane amount of favor. And she's around a lot of favor too that she can get. So got her deadly finesse. And receive training. So that's these cards over here. Once again, pick 2. She's turned into a powerhouse, man. Brutal finisher. Gain +1 attack for each other card in your combat stack. That's awesome. And it does 3 automatically. It costs 4. So normally it's doing 3 injury, but this could do maybe 8 injury. That's incredible. Outmaneuver. Choose a card type next round. If your opponent does not play that type, his card is canceled. That's really good. And it has, but this is better. I'm just going to say it straight up. Like, that is just better. So put that back over there. This goes into her hand. Remember, folks, that doesn't go get lost in there. Immediately goes into her hand. But I'm just going to play this and have them discard it anyway. I don't know. We'll see. But really, Barovor is in good shape right now. And actually, so she just did her quest. And yeah. So now she gets to keep going. So that advanced quest has taken her all the way up here. Now, she has to do it, though, by the end of the game. So she needs to sort of maybe start making her way up there, I guess. Explore the ruins of Angmar. But, God, there's so much more to do here. Also, there's, there's this plot. But I think she's going to leave that up to, well, I don't know. Geez, you know what she could do? She could actually go down and meet Eleanor and give her hella favor. Actually, she's kind of far away though, but she can blast through these perilous locations like pretty quick. Should she do that? Gotta play this live one time so I can do a call in call out there and have you guys comment, don't do it, Barovor. I guess next turn she can do her quest, really, without too much problem. Oh, I should have put some more. Well, I didn't know that's her quest, so. She could try and dislodge this plot, too, but she's got a whole heck of a big, because she just healed. But Silt, see, she's really low on favor. That's her problem. So she probably would try and do her quest to get the favor. It's also, it's very nice for her to finish a quest because she gets an extra, favor. And this gives her 2 favor, so that would be 3 favor right there, which would actually be enough to dislodge that. So I think she might do that.